pH calculation we have done, no? Okay. Pressurize on salt hydrolysis. Salt hydrolysis, okay? Salt hydrolysis is what? Suppose you have an acid, HA plus, and a base, DOH, and the reaction it gives what? BA plus H2, where this BA is a salt. BA is a salt, correct? So hydrolysis of salt is, means what? When you mix water into this salt, the reaction should go in backward direction. Okay, that is what we are talking about. It is a neutralization reaction. Acid-base reaction is what? Neutralization reaction. So hydrolysis of salt is what? The reaction of salt plus water. Okay, this reaction goes in backward direction. So salt hydrolysis, what we can write, right turn into this, it is a reverse of neutralization process, reverse of neutralization process. So the reaction of this is what? Suppose you have a base BA, sorry, salt BA plus H2O. This gives what? This gives? HA plus BOH. We'll discuss that. It depends. In general, it is exothermic. Dissolution process are in general exothermic. Hydrated salt, if you put, it is then endothermic. But in general, dissolution process is exothermic in nature. Okay? BA gives you this. Suppose you have a cation here, B plus, plus H2O. What is the product we get here? BOH plus H plus. And the anion is A minus plus H2O. It gives AH or HA plus OH minus. This is the two reaction possible in hydrolysis of salt. Because salt is what? Like you see NaCl. NaCl exists as what? Na plus and Cl minus. So when you dissolve water into this, this Na plus reacts with water or Cl minus reacts with water. So in these two reactions, when this positive charge ion and this negative charge ion of the salt react with water, it either gives you H plus ion in the solution or OH minus ion into the solution, right? So when it releases H plus ion into the solution will have acidic nature. When it releases OH minus ion, the solution will have basic nature, okay? So here also we have to find out the pH of the solution, okay? The pH of the solution. Understood this, right? So first case we have, here we have four cases possible. Strong acid and strong base we can take. Strong acid and weak base we can take. Weak acid and strong base and weak acid and weak base. Okay? So in all the four cases, we have four different formula of pH. Okay? The first possibility you write down of salt hydrolysis. Hydrolysis of salt of strong acid and a strong base. Strong acid and a strong base. A strong acid, any example?
HCl.
Strong base?
NaOH.
So when HCl and NaOH reacts, it forms what? NaCl plus H2O. So hydrolysis of this salt is what? This gives you Na plus and Cl minus ion, right? So hydrolysis of this salt means the reaction of Na plus H2O, and this gives NaOH plus H plus, okay? And Cl minus gives you HCl plus OH minus. Okay, this is the cation of the salt of strong acid and strong base. Okay, cation of the salt of strong acid and strong base. anion of the salt of strong acid and strong base, correct? So the hydrolysis of, write down this, this is your favorite studio. Write down, the hydrolysis of the cation of the salt of strong acid and strong base, strong acid and strong base, and the hydrolysis of the anion of the salt of strong acid and strong base. Hydrolysis of the anion of the salt of strong acid and strong base is not possible. Is not possible. Okay? This means what? When Na plus reacts with H2O, it forms NaOH, right? So NaOH is what is a strong base. So in the solution, it exists as Na plus and OH minus. Complete dissociation will be there, right? That's why this reaction has very less tendency to go into forward direction. The reaction goes in backward direction. Okay? This reaction is not possible because if initially we have Na plus, if this forms also, it exists in the form of Na plus only, Na plus and OH minus. So net effect is not there. Okay? That's why we generalize what? That the cation of the salt of strong acid and strong base does not go under hydrolysis. Same reason we have here also. Cl minus, this also dissociates and forms Cl minus because it is strong acid. So this reaction also has tendency to go in backward direction. Correct? So this kind of solution is completely neutral and pH of the solution is 7 at 25 degrees Celsius.
Wait, sir, even if we change the temperature, pressure or other external
then pH factors, will change.
Yeah, then
so then pH
it, will have, it could have tendency to go forward.
It will be neutral. It will be neutral. The reaction overall is neutral. pH will be some other value, depends upon the Kw value of that, the temperature according to that, what is the value of pH plus pOH, accordingly we'll write down the pH value. But overall the solution will be neutral, it won't change. Because whatever effect we have here, the same effect we have here also. So equal number of H plus and OH minus ion will get, both will get neutralized. Okay? So overall the solution will be neutral. Next write down, the second one, hydrolysis of salt of weak acid and strong base. Salt of weak acid and strong base. Weak acid, any example? CH3. COOH, strong bases, NaOH. What is the product? CH3COONA plus H2O. Salt is this. And this is a salt of what? Weak acid and strong base. Salt of weak acid and strong base. What are ions we have here? CH3COO minus and Na plus. This is the cation of strong base. Hence, hydrolysis is not possible. No hydrolysis for this.
Yeah. For that. Yeah.
Okay, no hydrolysis. But this will go under hydrolysis. So for this one, hydrolysis possible. Okay. Now one thing you consider here, this reaction is reversible in nature, right? But this reaction is not reversible. I said there are four different possibilities. Strong acid, strong base, weak acid, strong base, weak acid, weak base, weak acid, and strong acid, weak base. Okay? All these four conditions, only the first reaction is irreversible in nature. Because this reaction has no tendency to go into backward direction. Because hydrolysis of both ions is not possible here. Only this reaction, which is the reaction of strong acid and strong base, this reaction is irreversible in nature, but all the three reactions are reversible in nature because this CH3CO- may react with this H2O and goes, the reaction goes in backward direction. Understood this? Okay, this is one difference you must keep in mind. Now, the reaction of this with water is what? If I write down here, CH3COO- plus H2O, and this gives CH3COOH plus OH minus. What is the nature of the solution?
Basic,
because we are getting OH minus I into the solution. So pH value should be what?
Greater than 7.
pH value should be greater than 7. So when you derive the expression for pH for this, you'll get 7, more than 7 value you are getting over there. Okay, which is logically correct. Correct? Okay. Now, the concentration of this, suppose I am assuming C. We are getting? This is 0, and this is 0 initially. And this becomes C minus CH. H is similar to that alpha, but it is degree of hydrolysis. There is degree of dissociation, H is degree of hydrolysis. This is CH and this is CH. Okay? Write down this H is. Can you write down the expression for KH for this? KH expression for this? Concentration of CH3COOH. Concentration of OH minus divided by the concentration of, correct? Okay. If I multiply with the concentration of H plus here, and in the denominator also if you write down H plus, what is this term?
Huh?
It is KW. What is this term? What is this term? Huh?
K.
1 by K. Equilibrium constant is for acid is K. So 1 by K is this. Okay? So KH, what we can write? So we'll find out the expression of pH in terms of KW. This is one relation. Okay? Now, again, the KH expression here, we can write this as concentration of this into this is C square H square, and this is C into 1 minus H. Okay? Now I'm using this expression. This into this by this minus H plus, you just let it be. So we can write down this, and this KH becomes.
So K is just the formation of an acid, right?
What?
KA
is the equilibrium constant of an acid. Suppose when you write down HCl, there my way example is or CH3COOH. This ka dissociation kaise hoga? CH3CO minus NH plus.
Yeah.
So its equilibrium constant how do we write? Concentration of CH3CO minus into H plus divided by concentration of CH3COOH. Okay? Since it is an acid, so its level K likh rahe. So 1 by K is that. Okay? CH3COOH, dissociates as this. Equilibrium constant for this reaction is what? Product by reactant. So this into this divided by this. So this into this by this is K. A stands for acid. Okay? So 1 by K is that expression. This divided by this into this is 1 by K. Okay? Now, if I take this assumption, 1 minus H is almost equals to 1, degree of hydrolysis is negligible. What is H? H is equals to KH by C and root over of it. Okay, KH by C, root over of it. Why we are calculating H here, degree of hydrolysis? And what we have to find out?
So when do we neglect H?
Why is H there?
H can, see, for, you don't have to think about that actually. When you do the derivation, you take the degree of hydrolysis very negligible. There is no condition of when we can neglect H. Like alpha we have done last class, no, when we neglect alpha, when it is less than 0.05, okay? Like that we don't have such conditions. But when you get this hydrolysis of salt, you have to assume this, the degree of hydrolysis is very negligible, okay? So the formula will get with this only. So you have to take this always. It's not like alpha, when we have to neglect and when we have to consider. You don't have to take that into consideration. So H is equals to KH by C root over of it. Why we are calculating H here? What is the purpose? Why we are doing all this calculation? To find out pH of the solution. And pH we find out for the ionic energy. Everywhere we are calculating pH only. So pH ke liye what we need? H plus concentration. H plus to hai nahi yahan pe, but OH hai. POH to nikal sakte hai, and then pH we can find out. So what is OH concentration? C into H. So H we know, then we can find out the CH
also.
So this, for this OH concentration is CH, that is why we are calculating this H. Okay? So the concentration of OH minus is what? The concentration of OH minus is equals to C into H, which is nothing but root over of C into KH. And what is KH? KW by KA. Because this K and K, KW you know already. K will be given in the question. Okay, so this is equals to C into KW by KA. Okay, this is concentration of OH. Okay?
No, so it's KH by.
No, it's
not.
Okay? Now, if you take minus log of OH minus, both sides will take log. What will get minus half of log of C into KW plus log of, sorry, I take this, minus log of K, is it right?
Yeah.
Okay. What is minus log of K? BK. Minus log of K is BK. And this we can write
C plus K.
Minus half of log C plus or minus half of log KW minus P K. Okay, minus log of KW is what? At 25 degrees Celsius. KW is 10 to the power minus 14. Are you jinda ho? At 25 degrees Celsius, KW is what? 10 to the power minus 14. So we can substitute this here.
So it becomes 7 plus 7.
Sir, shouldn't the half also?
Yes, sir, the half should
be
the
PK.
Half is there. So you to half here. Half of PK is multiplied. Oh, I forgot to give a lighter bracket. Anyways, so this is the thing. So this becomes what? 7, right? So can I write this as 7 minus half of log C minus, sorry, log C minus PK, okay? 7 minus half of log C minus, is it correct? So what is POH? Minus log of OH minus is POH. So POH is equals to 7 minus half of log of the concentration of what? What is C here? C is the concentration of CH3CO minus. Means the concentration of what? Concentration of acid that you get. CH3CO, what?
So you get the second last step, 7 minus half of log C minus. Should be plus.
Is it?
Yeah,
plus over na? The liquid plus. Okay, so I'll write down this one. BKA plus log C. This is the expression for pOH. You see, pOH is getting less than 7. When you substitute, you get less than 7 pOH. What is pH then? 14 minus pOH. That will be
7 plus
half of this. One thing is very important here. I'll write down the reaction first. The reaction was this: CH3COOH plus NaOH. CH3COONA plus H2. Okay. Now in this, you see, if you take 5 equivalent or molar, any concentration term you can write, 5 equivalent of this acid and 3 equivalent of this base. Okay, 5 and 3. Equal equivalent we do not have. The number of equivalents of acid is more than that of base. Then what is the number of equivalent of salt form here?
3.
Are one reacts with one, so three reacts with three, and NaOH won't be present in the solution then. What is the limiting reagent here?
NaOH.
How can you apply limiting reagent when it's weak?
No, wait.
But Na can't get hydrolyzed.
No, but it's like that, and one equivalent should react with only one equivalent.
Right?
Yeah, so it's
so you can't put.
This reacts completely?
Yeah, exactly.
How many equivalent of this or concentration of this left?
Two.
Equivalent of this left and 3 equivalent of salt forms. Okay, so what is the pH of this solution? In this, we cannot use this formula actually. This formula we cannot use. However, it is a reaction of weak acid in a strong base, because this solution is a buffer solution now. You know what a buffer solution?
Yeah.
Buffer solution forms when by the combination of a weak acid and its salt with a strong base. Weak acid and its salt with a strong base. So this is a weak acid, salt with a strong base, because in this solution you have the CH3COOH present and its salt with a strong base also present. This solution is now behaving as a buffer solution.
So if you increase the acidity, you will neutralize the acid.
It has tendency to resist the changing pH of the solution when you add a small amount of acid or base into it. So next topic is buffer solution, we'll discuss that over there. But the point is, you cannot randomly use this formula. You have to check the concentration of acid and base that you are using. If it is 5 and 5, okay, if it is 5 and 5, if it is 5 and 5, then this and this reacts completely.
Yeah.
Now there is no more acid present into the solution. We have only salt. Then we can use the formula of salt hydrolysis.
But if I had everything react completely, then will it still be a buffer?
No, it's not. For buffer solution, like I said, there are three types of buffer solution. One is when weak acid and salt with strong base is present, that forms a buffer solution. So when these two react completely, there is no acid present, but we have only salt, then we use the formula of salt hydrolysis, not the buffer solution formula.
So then how do you solve the buffer solution?
Salt hydrolysis. So this you must take care of. You just cannot use the formula of this when you see the reaction like this. You have to check the concentration of acid and base, and then you can accordingly you can apply the formula. Okay? Is there a question actually need maybe? Okay? If you use this pH value, pH formula, you'll get an answer there, option of the formula. Right? So that's what I said in the beginning. You have to identify how big on the condition and what formula you have to apply for pH. Okay? Okay,
wait, sir, if it was three equivalents, then what are we supposed to do to use this one?
What three equivalents?
If any of it was three equivalents.
That comes under buffer solution, acidic buffer that is. So we'll discuss in buffer solution separately after salt hydrolysis. Okay, so that we let it be now.